Good morning, children. Today, we are going to discuss about the human excretory system. So, in the previous class, we discussed about the excretory organs of different types of organisms, right? Today, we'll be discussing about human excretory system. So, before going to the human excretory system, first of all, what is excretion? That one we have to remember. What is excretion? The excretion means elimination of nitrogenous wastes to maintain ionic balance. That is called excretion, right? So, we discussed the modes of excretion. What are ureotelic, uricotelic, ammoniotelic? Like that, we discussed in the previous classes. So, ammoniotelic, which releases the ammonia. Ureotelic, which releases the urea. Uricotelic, which releases the uric acid, excretes the uric acid. So, like that, we discussed and excretory organs of different organisms like protonephridia, metanephridia, flame cells, Renetti cells, solenocytes, metanephridia, malpighian tubules, antennal glands, green glands. Like that, we discussed. So, today, we are going to discuss about human excretory system. Human excretory system. Today, structure of kidney we are discussing. Which one? The structure of kidney. Excretory system in human consists of a pair of kidneys. How many? Excretory system of human consists of how many? A pair of kidneys. Next, a pair of ureters and a urinary bladder and urethra. Okay, excretory system of the human consists of pair of kidneys, pair of ureters, urinary bladder and urethra. Kidneys are reddish brown. So, which color kidneys are? It's a neat bit. Okay, kidneys are which color? Okay, kidneys are in which color? The kidneys are in reddish brown color. What is that? Reddish brown color. First point. Now, which shaped? That is also important point. The kidneys are reddish brown color and which shaped? Bean shaped. This is important. Bean shaped structures. Okay. Next, that lie in the superior lumbar region between the levels of the last thoracic and third lumbar vertebrae. Last thoracic and third lumbar vertebrae. Very important. Neat bit. What is that one? Lies in the superior lumbar region between the last thoracic and third lumbar vertebrae. You know, cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacral, coccyx, like that, you know, vertebrae is there. So, the last thoracic and third lumbar vertebrae between this bean-shaped kidneys are there. Next, they are close to the dorsal inner wall of the abdominal cavity. Close to dorsal inner wall of the which one? Abdominal cavity. The right kidney is placed slightly. Right kidney, very important bit. Slightly lower than the left kidney. Lower. The right kidney slightly, okay, kept lower than the left kidney. Next. Each kidney, another important point, this is a very important point, you have to remember, each kidney weighs average 120 to 170 grams. Each kidney average weighs 120 to 170 grams. The outer layer of the kidney, what is I'm telling to you? The outer layer of the kidney is covered by 3 layers of supporting tissue. Okay, 3 layers of covering supporting tissue. What is that one? Renal fascia, peripheral fat capsule. So, peripheral, renal fascia, and peripheral, what is called? Perirenal fat capsule. What is called? Perirenal fat capsule and fibrous capsule. What is that one? Renal fascia, perirenal fat capsule. Suppose renal fascia, perirenal fat capsule, and fibrous capsule. Like this, three layers covering supporting tissue is there on the kidneys. Okay. Once again, children, the human excretory system. What we are discussing? The human excretory system consists of pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, urinary bladder, urethra, kidneys, reddish brown, bean-shaped structures. They lie in the superior lumbar region, last thoracic and third lumbar vertebrae, close to the dorsal inner wall of the abdominal cavity. Right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney. Each kidney weighs an average of 110 to 170 grams. Three layers covering supportive tissues: renal fascia, perirenal, fibrous capsule. Next, longitudinal section of the kidney. If you cut the kidney longitudinal section, if you see what you will be there, what will be there, that is important. Longitudinal section of the kidney. Okay, first one. So first point you have to see carefully. The longitudinal section of kidney shows an outer cortex, very important bits, outer cortex, inner medulla and pelvis. Outer cortex, inner medulla and pelvis. Outer cortex, inner medulla and pelvis. Okay. Next, the medulla is divided into few conical tissue masses called medullary pyramids. Medulla is divided into few conical tissue masses. What is called? Few conical tissue masses called medullary pyramids. Okay, what is called? Medullary pyramids. The part of cortex that extends in between the medullary pyramids is the renal columns of Bethany. So this is a very important. So the part of the, what I am telling you, very careful. The part of cortex that extends in between the medullary pyramids. Okay. The cortex is there, right? The cortex. Okay. The part of the cortex that extends between the medullary pyramids called, that is called renal columns of Bethany. Renal columns of Bethany. That is important. Okay. Renal columns of Bethany. So this point, you should be very, very careful. Okay. Extends between the medullary pyramids. Okay. What is called? Renal columns of Bethany. Okay. Renal columns of Bethany. Renal columns of Bethany. Okay. So one more time. I repeated this point. The part of cortex that extends in between the medullary pyramids is the renal columns of the Bethany. Next one, what is the next point? So, surface, the center of the inner concave surface of the kidney. The center of the, very, very important. The center of the inner concave surface of the kidney has notch. Inner, once so notch is there, that is a very important, that notch. That notch is called renal hilum. Called renum hilum. You see here the notch is there or not, like this. So this is called renal hilum. So this hilum, the center of the inner concave surface, okay, of the kidney has a notch called renal hilum, through which, what will happen? Through which a broad funnel shaped renal hilum, which projections called calluses, blood vessels. Okay, very important. Hilum is a broad funnel shaped space called renal pelvis, which projection called calluses. Next, what is that one? Renal, through which, renal hilum, through which ureter, blood vessels and nerves innervate. Okay, what are those? Ureters, blood vessels and nerves innervate. Next, inner to the hilum is a broad funnel space is called renal pelvis. So, inner to the hilum, broad funnel shaped, that is called renal pelvis with projections. What you call? Called calluses. Renal pelvis with projection called calluses. This, the calluses, okay, the renal pelvis, okay, continues with the ureter. Continues with the ureter once it leaves the hilus. So renal pelvis continues the ureters once it leaves the hilus. Okay, hilum, that is important. The walls of very important point. The walls of the calyces, pelvis, and ureters had smooth muscles. Okay, they have very smooth muscles. The walls are very made with what? Smooth muscles. This point important. Smooth muscles. Okay, smooth muscles. These smooth muscles walls contracts rhythmically. Contracts rhythmically. The calyces collects the urine. The calyces collects the urine and empties into the ureter. The calyces collects the urine and empties the ureters, which is stored in the urinary bladder temporarily. So the calyces collects the urine and empties into the ureter, which is stored in the urinary bladder temporarily. So urinary bladder temporarily. Next, the urinary bladder opens into the which one? Urethra. Urinary bladder open into the urethra through which urine is expelled out. Through which the urine is expelled out. Okay. Observe very carefully, children. The longitudinal section of kidney, if you see, outer cortex, inner medulla, pelvis, medulla and few conical tissue masses called medullary pyramids or renal pyramids. The part of cortex that extends in between the medullary pyramids, renal columns of Bethany. So the part of cortex that extends in between the medullary pyramids is the same. What I said, repeated this point, renal columns of Bethany. The center of the inner concave surface of the kidney has a notch called renal hilum, through which ureter, blood vessels and nerves innervate. Inner to the hilum, renal pelvis with projection called calyces, they connect open to the ureters, leaves through the hilum. Next, walls contract, the smooth muscles of the walls of these all vessels called structures contracts rhythmically. The calyces collects the urine and empties the ureter. Then the urine will go and temporarily store in the urinary bladder. Through urethra, urinary bladder to the urine will be expelled out. So these all are the what you called longitudinal section of the kidney parts. Okay, next come to another important, that is called structure of nephron. What you are calling structure of nephron. What is the nephron? First of all, what is nephron? Nephron is the structural and functional unit of the kidneys. Each kidney has nearly 1 million complex tubular structures. How many? Each kidney have 1 million complex tubular structure called nephron. What is called? Called nephron. 1 million complex tubular structures called nephron. So this nephron is very important to filter the blood and to get the waste urine, that is the urine will be filtrate or urine will be formed because of the or by the reason of the nephrons. So the nephron consists of filtering corpuscles. Nephron consists of a filtering corpuscles called renal corpuscle. What is called? Renal corpuscle. The nephron consists of a filtering corpuscle. The corpuscle is means nothing but glomerulus with the malpighian body. So you know very well. So and a renal tubule. So this is called malpighian body and a renal tubule. Together, malpighian body and renal tubule together, longer tubule called collecting duct. Malpighian body and renal tubule is there. And also what you call longer tubule also there, that is called collecting duct. So if you see the parts of the nephron, Bowman's capsule, glomerulus, proximal convoluted tubule, distal convoluted tubule, ascending loop of Henle, descending loop of Henle, and the collecting duct. Like this, there will be parts are there. So each nephron consists of filtering corpuscles called renal corpuscle, malpighian body, and a renal tubule. Okay, so the renal corpuscle nothing but what? Malpighian body and renal tubule. Next, renal tubules open into a longer tube called, this renal tubule open into a longer tube called what you call collecting duct. The renal tubules, okay, the renal tubules open in what you call open into the long tubule called collecting duct. Next, double walled cup shaped structure called the Bowman's capsule. Double walled cup shaped structure called Bowman's capsule. In that, what will be there? Blood capillaries are there. That is called, you know very well, glomerulus. What do you call that is? Glomerulus. Like this, the nephron, what do you call, parts are there. So, related to the nephron, so many concepts will be there and the diagrams also will be there. That one we will be discuss later. So, once you should observe very carefully. So, what is that? The nerve, blood vessels and nerve innervate into the ilum, then to the renal pilus with the projections called calyces. They will come out connected to ureters, leaves through the ilum. The smooth muscles of walls contracts rhythmically. The calyces collects the urine and empties the ureter. The urinary bladder have urethra. Then, you know very well, urinary bladder urethra will be, urinary bladder once filled through urethra, the urine will be expelled out. And the structure of nephron, if you say, the structure is a structural and functional unit of the, nephron is a structural and functional unit of the kidneys. There will be 1 million complex tubular structures called nephrons and filtering corpuscles, renal capsule and renal tubule, and renal tubule, longer tubule, open into the longer tubule called the collecting duct, the double walled cup shaped structure called Bowman's capsule. The Bowman's capsule consists of blood capillaries. The blood capillaries can also called, what you call, glomerulus. What you call? Glomerulus. So, what are the bits from this? First neat bit. Which color? Reddish brown. Okay, what is the color of the kidneys? That is the first bit. That is called reddish brown. And the location of the kidney. So, between superior lumbar region. Means between the last thoracic and third lumbar vertebrae, close to the dorsal inner wall of the abdominal cavity. So, last thoracic and third lumbar vertebrae. Next, average weight 120 to 170 grams. What are the three supporting tissue layers? Renal fascia, perirenal fat capsule, fibrous capsule. Okay, outer cortex, inner medulla, pelvis. So, this is important. And in between the pyramids, what is that one? So, in between the pyramids, the part of cortex extend in between the medullary pyramids is the, what you call that one? That is called renal columns of the Bethany. So, what is that notch? Another important point, the center of the inner concave surface of the kidney has a notch. That notch called, what is that notch? Notch is called renal ilum, through which ureter, blood vessels and nerves innervate. Inner to the ilum, there will be renal pelvis with the projections called calyces. Then ureters leaves through the ilum. Okay, so ureters means, you know, ducts, tubes. So next, smooth muscles. The walls of this ureter and this all parts contracts rhythmically. Because of that only, the urine will go and through ureters to urinary bladder. So, urinary bladder connected to the urethra. Once urinary bladder filled, so it will be open, the sphincters will be open, then urine will be expelled out. The structure of nephron, if you see, 1 million complex tubular structures, you know very well called nephrons. So, what are the parts? That is important. Bowman's capsule, glomerulus, that is called Malpighian tubule, the renal tubule, longer open into the long tubule called the collecting duct. So, double walled cup shaped structure called Bowman's capsule. The Bowman's capsule consists of blood capillaries called glomerulus, helpful for blood filtration. Tomorrow we will be discuss about filtration slits, what you call, and proximal convoluted tubule and distal convoluted tubule and nephron. function, how it will be perform the functions, we'll be discussing that tomorrow.